Can we pray for non-Muslims? Yes, of course, we should. But what kind of prayer? My colleague or my neighbor or my for reverts my their parents, their children, their spouses, or whatever their relatives who are non-Muslims. We should constantly pray for their hidayah. Definitely. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do that. And when they came to him and said, Ya Rasulullah, udu ala daws, pray against them that may Allah destroy them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allahumma hdi dawsan. Rather, he prayed for them, even though they showed resentment and an offense, yet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed for them. And when they heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what she kept saying, Allahumma hdi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. And they were the worst of disbelievers because they were pagans. And they fought against the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So rather he would say, Oh Allah, guide my people since they don't know. They don't know the severity and the danger of what they're doing. Allahumma hdi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. What about dua with shifa? One who's sick, non-Muslim, can we pray for him? Yes, if he is a good man, and we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him health and respite so that Allah will open his heart to accept the hidayah and be rightly guided, we'll pray for him. Can we recite ruqya on him? Yes, and that was approved by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We visit them too? Of course, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did so. Visiting the sick, whether Muslims or non-Muslims, he used to visit his enemies. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not just because they're non-Muslims, even non-Muslims and enemies, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would visit them. That brings comfort to the heart of other party, and it shows the beauty and the essence of Islam. This is the true Islam. There is only one thing that is restricted with regards to dua for non-Muslims. Whenever a non-Muslim dies in a state of shirk or kufr, then it is over. It is not up to us to pray for him or her. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, استغفر لهم أو لا تستغفر لهم. إن تستغفر لهم 70 مرة لن يغفر الله لهم. Whether you ask for forgiveness for them or not, even if you continue to ask for forgiveness for them 70 times. And the number 70 does not mean just literally 70, because the 70 was like the infinite number back then. Like when you say a billion times, it would never be accepted. Your dua to the non-Muslims, to the munafiqeen, those who died in the state of kufr, no matter how many times and how much you make dua for them, your dua will be null, will not be accepted, will not be looked at. And this is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibrahim alayhi salam promised his father, لَأَسْتَغْفِرَنَّ لَكَ وَمَا أَمْلِكُ لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. I shall ask for forgiveness for you, but I cannot avail you an art against Allah. I will just promise to ask for forgiveness for you, to pray for you, but I do not guarantee that Allah will answer my dua. فَلَمَّا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ أَنَّهُ عَدُوٌّ لِلَّهِ تَبَرَّأَ مِنْهُ. And once Ibrahim found out that his father is an enemy to Allah, he disowned his own father. And when did he find that he is an enemy to Allah? Well, Ibrahim's father from day one declared an enmity to Allah and to his deen. When he died in a state of disbelief, then he is not eligible anymore for dua, for rahmah, for mercy. Time is out. You're out of balance. There are many examples such as Nuh's son and Nuh's wife and so on.